Medical studies show paramedics across the country are getting a life-saving procedure wrong one out of every four times, often with deadly consequences.
While there is high-tech a way to make sure it's done right, Kentucky is not yet requiring that added step. Tonight, WLKY's investigative reporter Dwayne Pullman continues his series, Down the Wrong Tube.
When a patient can't breathe, paramedics turn to this, a tube to bring life-saving oxygen. But in a stunning number of cases across the country, paramedics send this tube down the wrong path. And worse than that, they often don't know they've made that mistake. Okay, so here we go. Paramedics let me try a key life-saving procedure.
I'm breaking the guy's teeth.
Placing a tube down an airway.
Okay. So I see that there.
Yeah.
Is this the tube?
Yeah, you can just put that in there.
To allow a patient in distress to get oxygen.
I don't see it.
Thankfully, that patient...
This guy's in distress, and I'm not getting a look.
...is a dummy.
Well, he hasn't had oxygen for a minute.
Yeah, he's not doing well.
With a lot of help...
This way.
Other way?
I got it right.
I got lucky.
You got lucky.
So did he. You're lucky.
I knew I got it right because of this.
Ready?
Dr. Neil Richmond of Louisville Metro EMS invested in high-tech software to monitor something very simple, carbon dioxide.
So this line down here is the patient's end tidal CO2. It's the carbon dioxide that they're breathing out. So every time they take a breath, it measures how much carbon dioxide they breathe out. It makes this little waveform.
It's called quantitative waveform capnography. Paramedics simply call it the dashboard. It's the only way to know for sure they've inserted the tube in the right place.
Without this, you're guessing.
Exactly.
According to scientific studies, without that dashboard, paramedics go down the wrong tube 25% of the time.
That means one in four. Not only is it misplaced, but the person who placed it is unaware that it's in the wrong place until the patient actually shows up in the emergency department.
Which can be and often is deadly.
If you then can't get the tube in, you got a dead patient.
All Metro Louisville EMS units are equipped with this high-tech dashboard to get it right.
This is the definitive gold standard. Your tube is in the right place.
But this gold standard is absent from many EMS units across Kentucky.
Why doesn't everyone have this?
Even though the American Heart Association has recommended quantitative waveform capnography since 2010, Kentucky's Board of EMS does not require the dashboard in its statewide protocol for paramedics.
There's no mandate.
And without a mandate or the dashboard...
Because it lets you know immediately, and there's no question.
Patients in airway distress...
You can see on the monitor how much distress he's in.
Run up 1 in 4 chance the crew they're counting on will get it wrong.
Should this be a priority?
Yes, this is absolutely should be, if not the number one priority, about as close to number one as you can get. It's time that we had the ability to monitor our airway management. Got to get the tube in the right hole.
Because it is life or death.
It is life or death.
Now, we've repeatedly tried to talk with Kentucky's Board of EMS, but no one has returned our calls, nor have they responded to numerous emails with requests for answers and information. Now, one of the hurdles to getting the new dashboard is cost. The software upgrade needed to monitor carbon dioxide costs as much as $5,000 per monitor. But at least here in Louisville, leaders have decided that cost is worth it. I'm Dwayne Pullman, WLKY News.